Hello, my dear loving student. Namaste to you all. Me as usual from Joint School family. My name is Moti Prasad Kordil. I am going to teach you as usual the class of Social Study, class 9. Lesson 5.3. So I think you have understood my previous lesson also. Today I am going to teach you about the topic constituent assembly. Generally this constituent assembly, it means in Nepali Samvidhan Sabha. Do you know what is the meaning of constituent assembly? In very short I am saying, in very short, I want to say you the meaning of constituent assembly to draft a new constitution. Very short and in lucid word, I want to say you that constituent assembly means to draft a new constitution. Clear? So before going through this lesson, first of all I want to clear the meaning of constituent assembly. A constituent assembly refers to the group of people elected. Group of people elected, nominated or selected by the people assigned for drafting, making the constitution as per the people's will and aspiration. As per the will and aspiration of people. So my dear student, this constituent assembly generally it is formed by a group of people to draft a new constitution. Clear? So after second people's movement, this thing it has been developed in our country to draft the new constitution. So for this, what happened? Already I have told you, people elected, nominated, elected. So for this constituent assembly election, CA means constituency assembly election, it has been done on 28 Chaitra 2064. 28 Chaitra 2064, and there were Total there were 601. So out of 601, we can say the first past the post. This is the direct method, 240. And this is the proportional method. Proportional method 335 and nomination, or we can say nominated 26, that means 601 total members were there. And in this method, very first past the post, this is the direct method. So where we can select the people, where we can elect the people by casting our valuable votes. So directly we have to choose 240, and this is proportional method. Proportional method, what happened, according to the party they will select 335. And Nomination from the different sector, 26. So 601 in this way total members were there to draft the new constitution. Clear? So this constituent assembly, it is work for the preparation of the new constitution, for the preparation for the new constitution. So what happened this time, sometime it has been given, but during this also it has been dissolved. The first constituent assembly was dissolved on 15 June 2069, because it cannot make the new constitution. Again on 4th Mangsir 2070, second election for constituency assembly has been done in our country, in our country. Clear? So this political party, the political parties of our country represent in the assembly, they could not maintain the political consensus, sahamati, on the major political issue of the contemporary society. So they failed to draft a new constitution as per the people's wills and aspirations. It was dissolved on 15 June 2069 during the prime ministership of Dr. Baburam Bhattarai. Clear? Again, a government was made under the chairmanship of the Khilraj Regmi, the then Chief Justice of the Supreme Court. So the political party, they agreed to conduct the election of CA under the chairmanship of the Khilraj Regmi, because no political party, they believe to each other. That is why the Khilraj Regmi, he has been made as the chairman of the government. Under his chairmanship, election, second constituency election was held on 4th Mangsir 2070. Nepali Congress appeared as the largest party in CA constituent assembly, and late Sushil Koirala, the then Prime Minister of Nepali Congress, was appointed Prime Minister of Nepal. Finally, the cabinet and the second constituent assembly, after very long exercise, after doing so exercise, they have been able to give the people to us. They have given the constitution on 3rd August 2072 PS. So on 3rd August 2072 PS, we got the new constitution. And there are some formation of the constituency assembly is also there. Constituent assembly was formed on the basis of the mixed election system in Nepal. Constituent assembly was formed on the basis of mixed election system in Nepal. Second, from the first passed the post system, 240 member constituting one member from each of the 240 election constituency. So different election constituency were there in our country, in every part it has been divided. And proportional method 335, this proportional method 335 member considering the whole country into a single constituency. Partila Sahib Gareko Samanupatikma proportional method. And 26 member it is nominated by the cabinet. It is nominated by the cabinet from among the those who have contributed to the field of national life. the person who has done very good thing for the nation, from that also they can be nominated to the member of CA, Constituent Assembly. The Constituency Assembly in Nepal was formed to stabilize the complete democratic system in which the citizens have right to make the constitution development. It is highly accepted system to provide people with rights and make them more independent. So my dear student, in our country, so many times the constitution of our country has been reformed. But after the Second People's Movement 2062-63, we have made a very drastic change in the history of our country. We have made a constituent assembly, so we are towards the new constitution. So due to this, on 3rd August 2072, we have got the new constitution. Now, what are the inclusiveness of the constituency, of the constituent assembly? While selecting the candidate, now first listen here, while selecting the candidate for the first past the post election system, there was a provision of representation based on gender, geography and population according to the principle of inclusiveness. Inclusiveness, samavesh, all. Clear? Gender, caste, creed, all. In the proportional system, election system, there was a provision of at least 50% women. Through 50% women represent from each class or region. Here class means caste, creed. Clear? So this thing. In proportional election system, there was a provision of at least 20% women representation from each class or region. There was a provision of having at least 1/3 women representation elected through both the election system. So my dear student, up to here, I think you have understood. Clear? There was constitutional provision that the parties had to consider the representation of disadvantages, poor, peasant and physically challenged people while listing their candidate for the proportional election. In proportional election, what happened, from the different sector, the people, they can get opportunity to keep their views in the constitution. For example, from the disability also of people can be nominated. From deep dump also they can be nominated. From backward community also one people can be nominated. So in this way, they can raise the voice for the sake of their people, for the rights of their people. And at last, what is the tenure, samay, how much they have to period? According to the interim constitution of Nepal 2063, the tenure period of the constituent assembly was 2 years from the date of the first meeting of the assembly. But the term could be extended for 6 months if the drafting of constitution could not be completed by the reason of proclamation of the state of emergency to the country. As the reason, the first constituency assembly, it lasted for 4 years. Actually, the time, that is the 2 years, but due to some reason it can be extended, and it has been last for the 4 years. For the 4 year first constituency assembly it has been there. So my dear student, in this lesson what we can understood that constituency assembly, it is an assembly which is made for drafting the new constitution for our country. So my dear student, I think you have understood up to now, and today only this much. Thank you. Namaste.